Oh, look. There's a little Marion. Look at that face. Look at me. Everybody else is nice and serious. Here I am. This is the real. Look at that in the corner. I am a piece of Marion Berlin. Oh, this is Marion Berlin. Okay. This is me. Oh, my God. My name is Marion Mostny. My maiden name was Raphael. I'm 82 years old. I shouldn't say that, but I can't lie either.
My name is Kurt Mostny. I met only because she lived next door. Of course, she was a little girl. I was an old man of 18 already, and she was a little girl of 12. I didn't even look at her, but she happened to be there. And little by little, I got accustomed to her look. And we went out together, and then we finally married. They went very, very fast. You wouldn't believe it. 62 years sounds so long, but if you live it, it passes and passes and passes. Everything basically becomes a routine. I was lucky to get her because she's my best friend that I ever had and always will be.
You just do what needs to be done. You change your opinions here and there. You give in. Sometimes one gives in more than the other. But we have had, I would do it over again. That is all I can say. I would marry this same man over again.
Me too.
Okay, me too.
I'm originally from Austria, from Linz, a city in Austria, you know. I was born, I lived there until I was 17 years old. I wasn't going to school. And finally at 17 and a half, I went to Vienna because I was drafted into the army, where I stayed, until they kicked me out because Hitler was coming.
I was born in 1927. I went to school in 1933 at 6 to a German school where we belonged. And in 1934, Hitler, was in charge of Germany and decided that no Jewish children could be in any German school. So we got kicked out from one day to the next and went to a Jewish school, which already prepared, we didn't know that, I was, 7 years old, 6 or 7, but they already prepared the Jews for a dark future. They always said, how can he kill all the Jews? How can he, how? This is propaganda, the guy is not gonna last. Well, that's how they got so many millions to kill, because too many people didn't believe him. Some people moved, rich people left Germany in 1934, 5 and 6 with their money. Then came 37, 38, they didn't let anybody out with any money. You could leave if you had the place to go with absolutely 10 mark. Which was about, maybe 50 bucks a person. They found this old aunt that they had, in Argentina, who had moved to Chile. And when we got there, you were allowed, I think, to take some carpets and some dishes. And everybody tried to sell that when we got to Chile to make money. But the problem was that too many people showed up at the same time with the same things. So, the Chilean people, who were very nice, they of course took advantage of it, which I don't blame anybody. They had, 30 Jewish families selling stuff the same thing and paid basically nothing. So in the end, you lost all your memories and all your stuff, and but the money fed you for, you know, a month or two or three. My mother tried to get her parents, who did not get a visa, from Chile. She was already in Chile, trying to get a visa for the parents, for the grandparents. And that was very difficult, and it cost a lot of money, which of course we didn't have. And my aunt, who got us to Chile, didn't have that much money. She had already paid for us, the visas. And in 39, September the 3rd, the war started. And that was the end of it. That's when Hitler had the concentration camps opened, the war started, and nobody made it out. After September, you know, so there was no visa for my grandparents, who ended up in a concentration camp and killed. The other family of my father, we had cousins there and uncles and aunts, all disappeared.
Thing is that I hope that nobody will forget what Hitler did. This mass murder, the man, he not only had on his conscience 6 million Jews, because of him 40 million young people died. He started this war, and between the Germans, the Russians, the Americans, the Allied, 40 million people had to die because of this fanatic. And you were powerless, you know. You couldn't do a thing about it. The only thing is what I always say, he lost the war because we survived him, and not he didn't survive us.
We wish all of our kids that they never, ever have to go through what we did.